Thinking I was lost here, but I don't want to lose you, love.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to do a video about fashion rules and which ones you should be following, which ones you shouldn't be following. I know there are some rules that are so dated that people still live by to this day. Like rules that when I was in high school and, you know, if you wore this, you were definitely like not cool. As always, these are my opinions on which rules I think should be followed and which rules I think shouldn't be followed and that are so dated and just need to be gone. So I will start with the rules that I think are dated and that you should be breaking immediately. Number one, the whole color mixing thing, and this was so huge when I was in high school. Don't mix black and brown and don't mix black and navy. If I remember if somebody wore a brown belt with black shoes to school, it was the talk of the day. I remember one time I wore a brown belt and black shoes. I pulled my shirt down so far and like tied it around my waist so my shirt wouldn't come up and you could see my belt. I remember it to this day. Black and navy was kind of the same thing. It wasn't really so much when I was in high school, but I remember that rule in college. You could not wear black and navy together. And I just think those rules are so long gone and you can most definitely be doing that.
Thinking I was lost here, but I don't want to lose you. Thinking of a stuck here, but deep down I can tell it's wrong. Feeling you now, take me breathing you now. Oh, taking me down.
Number two is don't mix metals. This was also something that used to be so big. If you were wearing all gold, you better not be wearing a handbag with silver metal on it. Absolutely not. I think the more metal colors, the better. Actually, that's not true. I don't know that I would wear silver, gold, and rose gold. I do think you should stick with just two, and it should be balanced out. So, you know, if you have on gold jewelry and gold in your shoes, you could definitely do, like, silver handbag, but also maybe a silver necklace. So make sure that everything's kind of balanced out, but it is okay to mix your metals.
You take me down.
Number three, don't wear white after Labor Day. I think some of the most beautiful winter outfits is an all winter white or a white coat or white jeans. Now, I do think you need to be careful about your materials. Like, would I wear white linen in the winter? Probably not. That's kind of a no-go, but you can definitely wear white after Labor Day. I do think that that is a rule that should have been broken a long time ago. People always say that you need to invest in your classics. You know, your white button downs, your blazers, that you need to invest in higher end pieces in order for them to last. And I just don't necessarily think that's true. I have a white button down that fits me so perfectly, that is so well made, that I have had for 4 or 5 years now, and it's from Target. There are places that do make well-fitting and well-made items that you don't have to break the bank for. You don't need to save up for a $300, $400 blazer just because it has a certain label on it. I do think that times are changing and things are being better made. Better made? I need to stop talking. Number five rule to break is to match your accessories. Long gone are the days that your shoes and your bag need to matchy-matchy perfectly. I think that, you know, the more mixing, the better, obviously. Like, don't be all over the place. Stay in the same color family, but it's definitely okay to mix and match your accessories. At the mall, and I was buying a pair of shoes, I had to have a bag that matched. You know, if I was buying, like, red flats, I would have to have a red purse to go with it. I wish I had photos of myself being, like, so matchy, but I don't. I probably burn them. Wearing too much of the same material. And I know this is kind of, it used to be a rule for denim on denim, and it also used to be a rule for leather on leather, suede on suede. And I even got a comment about it not that long ago of someone asking, how do I wear, you know, a leather jacket and a leather bag without looking like I'm wearing so much leather. It is about mixing up your textures. You know, I do think it's okay if you're wearing a leather jacket to wear a leather bag, but maybe have it be like a pebbled leather. As you look in the mirror and you don't just see leather, I do think it is okay to keep your materials in the same family, as long as it's not overwhelming. Something you can also do to break it up if you're wearing a leather jacket and leather booties, do a suede bag. I think that's a really good way to wear, if you're gonna be wearing all black or all the same color, just make sure you have a material in the middle that's breaking it up. Middle is so important. The middle breaks up everything.
It took my heart and showed me how time was moving slowly. Reading all the signs out loud, feeling you now. Take me breathing you now.
Oh, Persimmon rule to break is to never button to the top. I love a button down top, buttoned all the way to the top. I think it looks so chic. It obviously depends on what you're wearing with it, but I always, not always, most of the time I do button to the top. I just think it looks really nice, especially with like a slick back ponytail and some like trendy trousers, like a wide leg. Oh, I just think it's beautiful. Number 8 rule to break is that your face always needs to look done up. And, you know, I remember just growing up, people saying, oh, I can never leave the house without my lipstick on, or never leave the house without a full face of makeup. And I don't think that's true at all. I love wearing a bare face or just bare minimum out, you know, with an outfit. You know, it's one thing to be dressed in your lounge clothes and like, you know, wearing a bare face or going to the gym and wearing a bare face, but I do think it's okay to be dressed fully in an outfit and just having like a little mascara on. You know, I don't think you need to be wearing a full face of makeup every time you leave the house with your done up outfit on. Number 9 is to always look polished and put together. Just remember, you know, not leaving the house unless I had makeup and my hair was like perfect and my outfit was like perfect. I do think, you know, or like a shirt like fully tucked in, I do think that now it is considered cool to have, you know, some messy elements. So, you know, if you want to like mess your hair up a little bit and give it like a little tease, or like untuck one side of your shirt or do a front tuck, I do think it's again about the balancing act. So if you are going to have, you know, a white button down top and you only have like one side tucked in, which I love that look, but then, you know, do something nice to your hair. So I do think it is a balancing act, and it is okay to have messy elements to your outfit. Like if you want to wear a wide leg and a sneaker, make sure you are wearing something nicer up top. Don't wear something big and baggy up top. Just pick one area to be messy and then, you know, fit yourself up in the other areas. And number 10, are we at number 10? Oh my gosh, number 10-ish. Is to never mix prints. And what? I don't even remember that rule, but when I was Googling it, I was like Googling fashion rules, you know, what are like fashion rules or what are dated fashion rules? Everyone said don't mix prints. And I was like, wait, hold on a second. I've always mixed prints. So I was doing something wrong. It is totally fine to mix prints as long as you know how to mix prints. Whenever someone asks me, long story short, how do you mix prints? I always say mix a big print with a small print, stay in the same color family. That's all you need to know. But it's definitely okay to mix prints. As long as you're adding a solid in there somewhere, maybe. And sometimes, you know, it's just case by case. But if your prints are kind of crazy, maybe do like a belt to break up your top and bottom, or, you know, a jacket to kind of like throw things off a little bit. But it's definitely okay.
Put your hands on my back, boy. Lead me to the brightest of my days. Wrap your arms around.
Follow always is to, number 1, know your body. Dress for your body. And I have linked a few articles below if you are confused on how to dress your body type, that maybe could help you. But for me, I am very straight. I'm not curvy. I have a very like slim athletic build. So you will probably not ever see me in like a tight pencil skirt and like a looser top tucked in. That's just not my body type. My body does not like that. You will see me in like an A-line skirt though, something that flares out, makes it look like I have hips. So that's just an example of me knowing my body and knowing how to dress my body. And there are times that I even like buy stuff and I put it on at home and I'm like, oh, this really doesn't flatter my body type. Number two is don't drown yourself in designer. One of the biggest, you know, fashion mistakes I see is I see people wearing, you know, a big Gucci belt with a Fendi bag and Louis Vuitton shoes with logo all over. And it's not even, I mean, you can definitely mix designer, but just be careful of how many logos you're wearing. Just limit yourself to one logo. And I know so many people have the Gucci belt and then they pair that with, you know, their other logo bag. And I say just stick, you know, you can wear many designers at once, stick with one designer logo. And it's one thing if your bag says, you know, like Givenchy, like really small on it, but I'm talking, you know, you guys know what I'm talking about. Number three is to not focus on the trends. Buy what you like, and if there's a trend that comes along and you like it, then, you know, buy a couple of pieces with that trend and pair it with your classics. But don't get so lost in the trends that you lose your own sense of style. I know right now the dad sneaker is such a huge trend, and I've seen so many people in my Facebook group, and you know, they say, oh, I'm not really a big fan of the dad sneaker, but it's everywhere, so like which one should I buy? I'm like, no, don't buy either of them. If you aren't a fan of this trend, first of all, don't waste your money, and second of all, you're not gonna love yourself when you're wearing this piece because you don't believe in it and you don't love it. And don't follow every single trend that comes along. You don't want to drown yourself in trendy items. I always say dress in classics, in your classic pieces, very minimal. And if you want to add one trendy piece to your outfit, I think that's kind of the best advice that I can give to someone who is focusing so much on the trends and, you know, you're just kind of overwhelmed. Number four is to always wear clothes that fit. And, you know, I know some things are made oversized, and that's not what I'm talking about. You know, they make oversized sweaters and oversized, you know, like dad jeans or mom jeans. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about if you see an item that you love and you're a size extra small and all they have left is an extra large, don't buy it. I don't even think a tailor could fix that. Don't buy it. Hold out until it's your size. Don't wear things that aren't your size. It's me working retail, women used to get so caught up mentally in sizes. They would come in the store and they would say, I'm a size 4. I'm not buying a size 8, even though the size 8 fits them. And I'm like, okay, but you have to understand that some designers just make things differently. So you're a 4 in this designer, but then you might be an 8 in this designer. It has nothing to do with you. I just think people mentally get so caught up in numbers and in sizes that they just don't, they buy something that doesn't fit them. And if you do buy something that is your size and it fits you great, but you just have a little bit of length to be taken off or a little bit in the waist, invest in taking it to a tailor. In the end, you'll thank yourself for it and it won't just be sitting in your closet going unworn. Five is to dress for the occasion and know your social setting. You know, if you are going to a wedding, but you just bought this really beautiful, super tight, lacy red dress that just really makes your boobs look great, maybe skip out on that. Wear that somewhere else. Wear that to a nice dinner. So I am all for wearing what makes you feel good, but just also know your social setting and where you're going and dress appropriately for the occasion. Number six is to not overdo it. And that is a rule that I do think you should follow. You don't want to lose yourself in your outfit, and you don't want to ruin your outfit with so many accessories. So, you know, if you've got nice big curly hair going that day and you know, really beautiful hoops on, maybe don't pile on a bunch of necklaces and a bunch of rings and a giant loud bag. You know, don't lose your outfit in stuff. Maybe keep your stuff to a minimum. Number seven is it is okay to make the occasional splurge. I know a lot of people feel guilty if they decide to splurge on something, me included. I bought, you know, my first Chanel bag a while ago and I had like a guilty feeling. I was like, I feel guilty. Why do I do that? But now I'm so glad I have it. So, you know, treat yourself every now and then if you have the means to treat yourself and really make yourself feel special is something that you've been wanting for a long time, it is okay to invest in a handbag. It's something that you can pass on to your kids one day, or you can pass on to, you know, your younger sibling or your niece or your nephew. Things like that just gain value over time. So I do think it is an investment piece. So it is okay to, you know, invest in yourself every now and then. Give yourself a little treat. Here's my last rule, and I don't want to classify this into a do or don't. I just want to throw it out there and just let the world have it, and you can do whatever you want with it. But here's my stance on wearing leggings as pants, okay? I think that there is a time and a place for leggings as pants, and it is hardly ever, but I just see so many girls who are walking down the street right in front of me, and I can see their actual butt crack. The actual butt crack. There are some leggings that are meant to just kind of be worn around the house, and I feel like those are most of my leggings. I do like to wear my leggings as like an athleisure look with like moto boots and, you know, leather jacket, but I do give them the bend over test for my butt crack. Will not ever wear my leggings as like an actual outfit. Like I would never put on a, you know, button down top and like a Baker Boy hat and like heels with leggings. I would just, you know, I think pants or jeans just look so much nicer. Next time you are grabbing those leggings as pants, maybe just think twice about it. Maybe just don't. I don't know, I kind of wanted to throw this tip out there just to get your opinion on it. Like, what do you think about leggings as pants? And do you agree with me that it is mostly because, not that they don't look good, you know, not that you don't look great, but most of the time I can see your butt crack. Like, the whole thing. And your underwear. That's just, like, problem number one. And just problem number two is that they just don't look so polished. And I do have... what are they called? From Zara. Zara sells them. They sell really good ones. Actually, they're like high-waisted riding pants. You know, and I think there is a time and a place for that type of thing because they do look like they're meant to be worn out of the house. I have some from Zara and I have some from Rack and Bone that have stitching on the front of them. And, you know, they do look more like you're supposed to wear them out. But as for like actual like Lululemon and Zella and Aloe, I do think those are just meant for the yoga studio and for the gym. So it's kind of a tricky situation. I kind of didn't want to classify it as a do or don't because I'm on the fence about so many things. I don't want to offend anybody. Your opinion. I'm gonna let you guys take this one away from me because I just want to stop talking now. Those are my tips. I hope you learned something from my tips. I hope you maybe took something away. And if you don't agree with some of these tips, that's totally fine. You know, not everyone is meant to agree on everything, and that's fine. These are just things that I live by and that I follow. And sometimes I break my own rules, and that's okay. You know, I don't want you to be like, last year you wore this, and that goes against your rules. Sometimes it just happens, and I forget my own rules, but this is what I came up with. This is what I'm living by at the moment. You know, things change down the line. Doing a giveaway, just FYI, I'm doing a giveaway. I went and bought some of my favorite stuff at Glossier. I have the Glossier perfume in there, which is one of my favorite perfumes. So you don't want to miss that. It's a really good giveaway. I threw some other stuff in there as well, but the link will be here and it will be below. So go check it out, go click on it, go enter. There are a lot of steps for the giveaway, so don't be scared at all the steps. You don't have to do all of them. You could just do one of them if you want to, but the more steps you take for the giveaway, the better chance you have of winning. So there's that. The LBH magazine signups are gonna be open soon. As you guys know, we turn off all signups for the magazine during the month because we were just getting flooded with signups, but signups will be open October 30th through November 2nd. So you have 4 days to sign up, mark your calendar, set an alarm to go remind you to sign up because they will be open soon. So stay tuned for that. I'll Insta story it, give you the link and stuff like that. So follow on Instagram. But yeah, those are my tips. Hope you like them. Hope you like these tips video. I'm kind of like liking doing them. I feel so bossy, which I don't like doing. But again, these are just things that I live by. You know, you don't have to follow them. So yeah. All right. Love you guys. See you later. Bye.